Good day, everyone. I am Edwina Estisagon from Mayor Calixto de Enriquez Elementary School from Rosario District. The title of my research is High Pipe Approach, a Health Education Program to Improve the Hygiene and Sanitation Practices of Learners. For the rationale, well-documented scientifically is the major transmission role children have had historically in the spread of respiratory infection. Generally, through their close interaction in schools and childcare centers. Moreover, children and teenagers aged 5 to 17 are considered to play the most important role in mass influenza, A, epidemics. While the lack of severity of COVID-19 in the children contrasts with that of other respiratory viruses such as influenza, similarities in the mode of transmission still exist. Recent studies have demonstrated severe acute respiratory syndrome, coronavirus 2 or SARS-CoV-2, does infect children, with about 50% of pediatric cases asymptomatic. Consequently, they may have an important role in transmission, alleviate of the lower levels than adult, and could be a silent transmitter, for example, infectious without showing clinical signs of disease. Worryingly, in many countries, it is common for children to be cared for or be in close contact with elderly people, for example, grandparents, the very age group of most at risk of acquiring serious respiratory complication resulting in death, according to Gray et al. 2020. For methodology, this study used three experimental methods, utilizing one group, pre-test, post-test design. The participants were the total enumerations of learners in the school. Thus, no sampling techniques was used. Data were collected using the survey questionnaire about the hygiene and sanitation practices adopted from the DepEdWash. After the implementation of HiPi program, survey was given again, which served as the post-test. The results of the pre-test and post-test were compared and analyzed using Wilcoxon sign rank test. For the findings, results revealed that the use of HiPi program improved the hygiene and sanitation practices of learners. And the implication, through this program, the learners are focused on improving wash in schools to ensure that their students stay healthy. It prevents diseases and infection, reduces absenteeism, improves the learning environment, and prevents the spread of communicable diseases from one student to another. For the conclusion of the study, results revealed that the use of HiPi programs improved the hygiene and sanitation practices of learners. Through this program, the learners are focused on improving wash in schools to ensure that their students stay healthy. It prevents diseases and infections, reduces absenteeism, improves the learning environment, and prevents the spread of communicable diseases from one student to another. The following are the recommendations of the study. Number one, Slack session with regards to the results of the study. Second, focus group discussion with regards to the plans of strategy based from the result of the study. Third, in-service training for the promotion of the intervention and strategy. Fourth, innovation of the intervention and strategy. These are the references used during the conduct of the study. That's all for my study. Thank you very much for listening.